Hi, I'm Natalia. Welcome to the studio. I'm a fashion designer, and today I'm really excited because I am ready to launch my website, my online store for my clothing brand and for my digital sewing patterns. I really want something beautiful and professional looking. I want a professional looking store. I'll be showing you step by step how you can create your own store with Wix. You can click the link down below to get started. I want to thank Wix so much for sponsoring today's video. Let's get into the tutorial. Go to Wix.com and click on Create Your Store. It's really easy to create an account, sign up. All you need is an email address and a password. I already have an account, so I will log in. Go to Create New Site. What kind of website should this be? Online store. Create your website with the editor. We're going to edit a template. And it will bring you to this page with tons of different templates. There's over 80 fully customizable online store templates, and there's over 500 fully customizable Wix templates. And then you can add the Wix Stores app to have the ability to sell online. I'm looking for something clean, simple, minimal, but choose whatever speaks to you. The one on the first page really caught my eye, so I clicked on View to get an idea of what the website would look like. I like it. I'll click on Edit. This is what the website template looks like. Before we add products, let's go back to the dashboard. We are going to create a logo. Type in Wix Logo Maker and start designing your logo. I'm going to type in my name and type in what my business is. I'm a fashion designer. And you can choose how you want your logo to feel. Wix will also give you a very quick quiz to get a feel of what type of logos you like, so they can recommend the perfect logo for you. I want this for my website. Click on that. Right away, I like the logos that Wix is showing me. I like the one with the hanger, I like the one with the black background, and I like this one. This is a very simple logo. Click on Customize. Wix will give you all different types of color options. I like the red one. This is what the logo would look like on my website, on social media, on business cards, on merchandise. This is a perfect tool. Back to the dashboard. If you don't have a business name, Wix can help you with that as well. They have a business name generator. Let's type in fashion, and it will generate all different types of names for you. Let's type in violet fashion. Right away, I like Violet Fashion Films. That sounds like a cute indie brand. Click on that, and you can get a custom domain name. Or if you have a premium plan, you can get a 1-year free voucher for a domain name. All right, back to the website. Let's add some products. Click on Manage Products and add new product. We're going to add my hoodie pattern for sale. Simply click on Upload File, Document, Upload Media, Upload from Computer. I select hoodie pattern. Once that has loaded, I click on Add to Product. Put in the name of the product, hoodie pattern, add a price, add a description, add photos. It's very intuitive. We're going through the same process, upload from computer, choose the photos you want to upload. Click open. I clicked on home and then selected the photos that I want for my listing. add to page. And just like that, the listing is done. I added some info about my product. Looking good. Click save. Next product. I selected one of the template products. The thing that I like about this, it kind of gives you a guideline of what to put in. Let's add images. This time I will be adding images of a red shirt that I designed. It's a button-down shirt. I'm adding in the photos. It has embroidery, has paint on it. It's really cool. Same process. Select the photos you want to add, click add to page. It's really easy to delete the other images, click on the X. And if you want to drag the photos around, just drag it. Very intuitive design. If you forgot to add a photo like I did, click add to page and add the other photo. Here I'm adding a price and a description. Click save, and I have my products added, two so far. I'm going to delete the rest of the products. Just click on the three dots and delete those template products. This is what my website looks like so far. Click on tote, change text, and type in your brand name. You can do this if you don't have a logo. However, I recommend adding your logo. Click on add, image, my image uploads. Click on your logo. Mine is in a PNG form. Drag it to the header. I created this logo a couple years ago. It's the same one on my clothing labels. Drag it and scale it to size. Delete the other text and place your logo in the location that you want it to be in. That looks good to me. Click on your logo and we will link the logo. Click on link, page, and current window for shop. So now when you click on your logo, it will open to the shop page. Now we will right click on your mouse and click on pin to screen. You can play around with the offset. This is so when you move your logo up and down, it will follow you. Next section. If you scroll down the website, you'll find the about section. Click on the about and click on edit text. Here you can type in whatever you want. You can type in about, you can type in info. You can change the size of the text in the text settings. I'm going to make mine a little bit smaller. Same thing with the paragraph, click on it, click edit text. I'll make my text a little bit smaller for aesthetics. Type in about your business. If you have writer's block, you can click on get text ideas. This is such a cool feature from Wix. Type in clothing store, about section, and this will generate text options for your about section. Copy and paste it in. Here you can adjust it a little bit. Such a great idea. Okay, I figured out what I wanted to write, so I pasted that in. You can change the text box elements by moving them up and down, dragging them. Let's go to the contact section. Click on contact, edit text. I'm deleting the template info and typing in my business email. Let's go to the socials section. Click on edit text. I am going to put in my social media and I'll show you how to link it. I selected Instagram, for example. I will paste in my web address for Instagram. Now, when you click on it, it will go straight to my socials. On the bottom, I'm just deleting
the other stuff.
I will go back to my dashboard. I will set up payment methods. Click on Get Paid. Confirm that your location is where it is. I'm in the US. Click on Connect for Accept Credit and Debit Cards. Make sure that you are not selling any restricted or prohibited products. I am not. I selected that. I click on Continue. This is what the Wix payment setup looks like. It will ask you your business type, personal details, your address, and banking info. Once that is done, click Submit, and it will work on verifying you. It'll take a couple of minutes, but once it is verified, then you can accept payments on your website with credit and debit cards. The next step is to set up shipping. Click on Set Up Shipping Regions. You can choose free shipping, or you can change the shipping rule. For international, I will change the shipping rule. You can do free shipping, flat rate, rate by weight, by price, rate by product. I will select the USPS calculated rate. And you can add different services, first class package, international, priority mail, all of that. I'll do first class and priority mail international. For package type, I will select small flat rate box. That's something that I can ship orders with. And that's done. Back to the dashboard. We will set up store tax. Add your country. I'm in the US and I am based in Connecticut. I put in the Connecticut tax rate and I selected tax on digital items and tax on shipping. Save, and that's done. Next step, let's select a site plan. There's three different business and e-commerce plan options. I highly recommend them if you are looking to sell your products. After selecting that, let's go to domains. You can add an existing domain or get a new domain. I have a domain that I purchased a couple years ago, so I connected my domain. But if you want to get a domain, it's very simple. Let's type in Violet Fashion Films, the name that we generated earlier, and see if that's available. It is available. You can get your first year free if you have a premium plan. Custom domains look more professional and credible, and they sell more. All right. So I played with my website a little bit more. Let's look at mobile. I like the way it looks on mobile. Very clean, very aesthetically pleasing. I will drag some of the info, the text boxes. And click Save. That's my website. It looks great. It looks beautiful. I'll publish it. And that is the website. So exciting. Let's click on a product. Look how cool. I love it. I'm obsessed. It looks so good. So clean, minimal. It's gorgeous. This is what my hoodie pattern looks like. I'm so excited. I really hope that this has inspired you to create your own online store.
Thank you so much for watching this tutorial. If you have any questions, comment down below. Don't forget to click the link down below to get started with creating your own store. Thank you again for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.